BWIQ is B&W Tech's chemometric software designed for both on and offline quantitative and qualitative Raman and NIR spectroscopy measurements. Today we are going to use BWIQ software to create a quantitative model that will allow us to rapidly predict the amount of methanol in contaminated spirits using portable Raman spectroscopy. Methanol-laced spirits are a global public health concern, as drinking spirits containing too high a methanol content can be fatal. Building a quantitative model requires creating a calibration curve with samples that encompass the typical upper and lower concentrations of real-life samples. For example, the EU defined the maximum allowance for methanol in spirits as 0.4% by volume, while drinking 5% methanol by volume spirits has proven to be fatal. Hence, our calibration curve for this model will include samples with methanol concentrations ranging from 0.3% to 5.36%. Once you have installed the BWIQ software, the data files for this example can be found in this folder. B&W Tek's iRaman Plus portable Raman spectrometer with BW Spec acquisition software was used to acquire measurements of samples with 9 different methanol contents within the upper and lower ranges. The same acquisition time and laser power were used for all acquisitions. 3 measurements per sample were collected. Upon inspection of the data collected, we can observe a positive correlation between the Raman intensity from the samples and the concentration of methanol in the samples, particularly from the peak at around 1,040 wave numbers, which corresponds to methanol. Now that we have our data set, we can open the BWIQ software to the pretreatment and training window. To input spectra files, go to File, Input, and select which type of files you would like to import. Locate the dataset and import the files into BWIQ. The data files now appear in the spectra window along with the corresponding spectra. Now that the spectra are imported into BWIQ, we need to add a variable to associate with each spectrum, in this case, the concentration of methanol for each sample. To add a variable, click the blue addition button in the upper left corner of the spectra window. A third column will appear. The name of the variable can be entered by right-clicking the header cell Y1, selecting Rename from the drop-down menu, and inputting a name. This is where we will input the values for methanol concentration associated with each spectrum. You can manually input the values by typing them from the keyboard, or you can copy and paste from a list of values in an Excel spreadsheet. Now that we have added variables to associate with our spectra, we will now apply a sampling algorithm to divide our 27 spectra into either calibration samples, samples we will use to build a calibration curve, or validation samples, samples we will use as a check to make sure the calibration curve is functioning properly. For this model, we will use a random sampling algorithm to randomly assign calibration and validation files. To select a sampling algorithm, click Sampling, then Random Sampling. The parameters for the random sampling algorithm will appear in the Algorithm Properties panel. In the Algorithm Properties panel, click Ratio and select 70 from the dropdown. This means we will designate 70% of the spectra as calibration files and the other 30% as validation files. To apply the sampling algorithm to the data, click the blue Execute button in the Algorithm Properties window. The Usage column in the Spectra window now shows which spectra are designated as calibration samples and which are validation samples. Spectra files can also be manually designated as calibration, validation, or ignored files by clicking the drop-down button under the Usage column. Files designated ignored will not be included in the final analysis. BWIQ software has several data preprocessing options, including smoothing, derivatives, and normalization algorithms. Preprocessing is typically applied in order to minimize background effects, spectral offset, and to enhance the signal differences related to the compositional differences in samples. Due to the simple matrix of these samples, these spectra do not require smoothing or derivation, and there is very little background fluorescence. However, the baselines of this data set are offset between the spectra. We will apply a multiplicative scatter correction to minimize the effects of the baseline offset on the data. Under Preprocess, select Multiplicative Scatter Correction. The algorithm is automatically added to the model and now appears in the Selected Algorithms window. In our data set, the spectral region between 700 and 2000 wave numbers is where we see the most pronounced variation in the spectra. Immanual variable selection can be applied to the data to limit the analysis to defined regions of the spectrum in order to exclude interfering signal or irrelevant spectral regions. Under variable, choose manual selection. Immanual variable selection is automatically added to the selected algorithms window. Next, we need to select a regression model to apply to the data. In this case, we will choose a partial least squares regression. Under regression, select PLS1. Note that the option PLS2 is grayed out, since in this data, there is only one Y variable defined. The PLS1 algorithm parameters automatically appear in the algorithm properties window. Click the blue addition button at the top left corner of the window to add the PLS1 regression to the selected algorithms window. The three algorithms that are listed in the selected algorithms window now make up the steps of our quantitative model. To save this training file with the extension .train, go to File, Save As, and Save the File. Training files can be saved at any time in the method development. To execute the method, click the blue triangle at the top of the selected algorithms window. A variable selection window will appear, allowing us to isolate the spectral region of interest. This can be done manually or by clicking and dragging the mouse over a region of the spectrum. Once the spectral region is selected, a separate window will open with all the preprocessing algorithms applied to the spectra in the data set. This is the model window. This model file with the extension .cmml can also be saved by going to File and Save As. The toolbar that now appears in this model window can now be used to view the plots associated with the model, including the calibration curve, residuals plot, and loadings plot. To view the calibration curve of the model, we can click on the first icon for predicted versus measured. The software automatically calculates the number of factors that best describe the data. Click OK to view the calibration curve. The blue data on the curve corresponds to the calibration samples, while the red data are the validation samples. The R, R squared, and root mean square deviation coefficients for the calibration and validation sets are also calculated, indicating the linearity of the calibration model. There are several other plots available to view the calibration and validation data, including loadings, variance, and residuals. Now that we have reviewed the model, we can use it to make quick, predictive measurements of suspected methanol-laced spirits. The BWIQ software can be connected to an iRaman series portable Raman system for quick, online predictions. For an offline prediction in BWIQ, multiple spectra files can be loaded at once to do batch predictions. Under Predict, select Load Spectra. Locate the prediction files you are looking to analyze in the correct file format. Import the prediction files into BWIQ. The window that appears lists the predictive data file names in the left column and the prediction values in the right column. Under Generate PDF Report, you can also save a PDF report which details the method parameters and the prediction values. If you have further questions about the BWIQ software, you can visit us at bwtech.com/support. Thank you for watching.